Okay, fine. So as I told, so Python is not a simple object-oriented programming. It is actually, it has a multi-paradigm, or it is a multi-paradigm shift, maybe what we can call it as multi-paradigm programming language. And it can support the different approaches. And one of the sub-approach is the object-oriented programming. Okay. So Python is a multi-paradigm programming language. So programming language. In this, actually, it supports different approach. In this, OOPs is one of the concept. So one of the approach of programming is the object-oriented programming, OOPs concept. Okay. Now, when I speak of object, okay, when I speak of an object, it has two characters. See, when I speak of an object, it has two characters. The one is, I call it as an attribute. One, I call it as an attribute. The second one, I call it as its behavior or what it is. Attribute and behavior. Okay. Now, let's give an example. Say, for example, let me take a person or maybe a dog or an animal, whatever it may be. Let me take a dog itself. Okay. Let me take an example. So, if I take dog, so usually if I try to name the dog, okay, if I try to name the dog, and maybe it may be of a particular age, it may be of a particular color, okay, it may be of a particular height, okay, or it may be a particular breed, etc. All these things are called as attributes. That means it's going to describe that particular object. That means description of the object. Description of the object. So these are called as attributes. Now, the dog can bark. So dog can, maybe it can bark and it can dance. Some example, okay? So if the dog, same dog can actually, if it can, the same dog, if it is, what it is acting, it is barking, okay? Maybe it's doing some other, maybe if I put a music, it's going to do some dancing, or it can catch a particular, maybe it is good at catching a particular thief or something. So it's good at maybe that some kind of an activity. That is an activity what it's going to do. So this is called as its behavior, okay? So if I describe a particular object, okay? If I describe a particular object, so these are called as properties. If you go back and look at it, if I teach thermodynamics, we call that as thermodynamic properties. So these are called as properties. So properties which are going to describe the object are called as attributes. And properties which says that it's going to do this thing, it can do this particular thing, these are called as activity based on it. Those are called as behaviors. Okay. Now, what is this actually? Now, when I come to this Python or your object-oriented programming Python, what it focuses? It focuses on a particular set of syntaxes, which I am going to write actually, which doesn't repeat itself. Whenever I write a particular, so when I write, right, see, the main object of, oops, let me write that. Okay. The main function of oops in Python is, so I am going to write a set of maybe syntaxes or set of codes actually, or the code what we call syntaxes, what I'm going to, which will not use. Okay, I'm not going to repeat it actually. Set of syntaxes which are not repeated. I think some books actually, as I read one of the books actually, they call it as don't repeat yourself. This is also based on a concept, actually. It's a concept, one of the book I have read, actually. They call it as DRY. They call it as don't repeat yourself. Okay. This is this concept is based on. So the concept of this is the principle on which actually your OOPS is built, actually. Okay. Now, what is a class? As I told, so this is an object. So object is nothing but I have to define an object based on its attribute and behavior. Now, I have to describe or define this object in different pattern. Okay. Now, if I try to, so maybe what our Kiran has told, that it is a blueprint of your object. So what is this blueprint actually? Blueprint is nothing but it's going to describing. So class is nothing but it is a description. It is the description of the object. It's a description of the object. Okay. And how am I going to define the object actually? This object is defined by its properties. Okay. The properties. Properties, and some books they call this as labels. So it doesn't matter. So it's a properties are labels. Okay. Now, just to think of a particular class. Okay. Now, think of a particular animal or a human being itself. Okay. Just think of an maybe one of the bird itself, a crow. So now, if I want to describe the cow, actually, crow. Okay. Or maybe your animal itself, cow itself. So what are the details I need to give? So maybe if I know the name of it, or if I know the what is its color, what is its size, okay, what is the height, okay, all these are called as descriptions. Okay. Now, whenever you want to define a class in a Python, so I have to start with, so the syntax is something like this. The syntax to define a class, the syntax to define the class is actually you have to start with the letter class and its name. So let me call it as cow and column. Okay. This is the syntax for defining the class. So this is the name. So it has to start with class. So class is a keyword. Look at this. This is a keyword. Okay. Here we use class as a keyword to define the class. So the name, and we construct. So based on this, actually, I can have n number of instances depending upon what I want to define it. So you want to define that particular class as a particular name. It is having a particular age. It has a particular thing. So all those things I can do that. Okay. Now object I have told. Object is nothing but, see, it is nothing but it's a character, or it's called as the instance. Okay, so an object is an instance of what I'm defining in the class. See, when I define a class, its description for the object is defined, has to be defined. When I define a class, I should clearly define or describe the object. Okay. Now, so let me give an example. Okay. Let me give an example. So let me write that. What is an object? So object is nothing but actually, it's actually an instance. So the object is nothing but it is an instance of a class, of initiation of a class. So instance of initiation of a class. Okay. Now, what is it actually? It is nothing but I am going to describe that object. So, when I try to define a class, when a class is defined, I am going to describe the object. So, the object is described or has to be described. So this is nothing but a class and an object. Now let us try to create an object or create a class. Let's try to create a class example. Let's try to look at an example of it. Okay. Now, so if you look at an example, so let me think of a particular animal. So let me think of a class of maybe a dog itself. So let me write that. A class dog. Okay. Now, as I told, I have to define the attribute of it. Okay. What type of dog it is? You see, this dog belongs to which species? So, if I want to define its attribute, so class attribute, I have to define it actually. So, it's something like it belongs to which group? It belongs to an animal group. Okay, so dog belongs to an animal group. So, let me call it actually species or something. Okay, let me call that as species of which one actually this is animal. If I'd have taken some something like a crow or something, I would have told that belong to maybe what we call it as birds. So here I've taken dog as an example. So I'm calling this as a species or which belongs to a group of what is called as animal. Okay, now I need to instance it. Okay, instance it means I need to describe it. Let me write that. I need to instance. I need to look at the instances. So here I'm going to use a function. So init function. I will describe about this init function in the next class. What exact is init function? I'm going to use this actually. This init function will be used extensively in your Python programming. I will tell about what is this init function and all. Okay. So I'm going to use that. It is a definition function underscore init underscore. I'm going to define that. Okay, so you have to define it something else. So I have to define as myself. What it is actually, I have to define it as myself. Somewhere I have to use it actually. So I can define that myself. Okay, these are nothing but variables. Okay, or arguments in your function. So myself, name, age. Okay, then close the bracket and you have the maybe verse column. Okay, now I have to define it actually. Suppose if I define myself dot name. Okay, you can define the name. Okay, myself dot age is equal to your age. Okay, now, so if I want to define, see, I have different types of dogs. Okay, maybe Pomeranian is one particular dog. Otherwise, what I will do, dog one, dog two, I am going to take. I am going to define dog one and dog two. So I have to initiate, see, here I have defined the instance of this particular attribute. So instance of this attributes, I have defined it. Now I have to create the instead, how many times I so I have to initiate this particular thing to initiate this dog class outside this particular thing actually. So if I want to do that, I should go outside, okay, and I call it as initialize, okay, initialize or initialize the dog class, whatever the class defined. The class defined. What are the dog class I have defined? It is a dog class actually. So maybe if you want, you can name it actually, maybe Pomeranian class or maybe some kind of your what you can have one or two types of dog category, you can do it. So what I'm doing is actually I am going to call it as dog one, some two varieties I'm taking. So dog one is one variety, dog two is other variety. So if I go here, what is it actually? It is a class of dog. So this is also a class of dog. Now I have to define its name. Okay, let me name it as maybe some Arvind. So just I'm giving some arbitrary name. Okay, it's of ages of maybe some 8 years. So maybe other one is maybe Tommy. This is of some 6 years. Just I'm giving an arbitrary name. I am trying to do. You can have n number of things. You can have such things, n number of things you are trying to call it. Now, what you have done actually, you have defined a class here. See, what you have done is you have defined a class. This is what we have done, a dog class. Under that, you are trying to see, you have defined a class and you are trying to do its attributes. You are trying to get its characters. What are the characters I am trying to do? Name and age. If you want, you can give color also. If you want, you can give height also. If you want to give its breed also, you can give. So lot many things you can give. But I am trying to give only two thirds. So it will be easy for you to understand. That's why I am giving name and age. If you want, you can give color also. Color, if I want to give, maybe one is a black color, other one is a brown color, other one is a maroon. So I can give, or a combination of two colors I can give. Okay. So I am trying to define the your particular class. That's what I am trying to do. Now, once I have done that, actually, I am going to call it. I am going to print it, or what I have done, whatever I have done, I can get it actually. I can get it printed. So access this particular attributes. So I need to see your class attributes are there. This is what I have. This is my class attributes. Now I will try to print this. Okay, print. I can tell. See, Arvind, this actually what type of class species? Okay, I will just tell that what type of what type of species it belongs. So it's an animal breed. It's an animal breed, I can tell. Or if you want to access to its attributes, instance attributes, I need to get this one. Okay, so this is access to its attributes, only attributes. Okay, that means what species, one of the species. So instance attributes means I'm trying to description. Same thing with the description. The same attributes with a description. Okay, so that is, if I want to define dog one, that is Arvind, is belong to what species, I should able to get it belongs to animal species. Okay, then Tommy belongs to animal species. If I want to get it, that belongs to accessing your class attributes. Okay, now instance attributes, if I want to access to it actually, then I should tell that your Arvind is of 8 years old, or Tommy is of 6 years old. If I'm able to get this, so the definition of your class with I'm trying to whatever I've described with what group it belongs and how it is described. So both I'm able to access from your Python code. And this is called as your hoops concept. Okay. This is called as your hoops concept. Is it clear? So now I'll try to print it actually. Just simply I'm going to print it. So just I will go. So accessing the class attributes. Okay, accessing the class attributes. Let me print. So let me tell that. So let me call it as Arvind or dog one, whatever it may be. So let me call it as Arvind is a what? It should be an animal. So that particular thing, it should be able to do that. So I could just put a format of what actually? Format of your dog one. I've defined it. Dog one dot underscore, it is your class. Okay. Dot species. Look at this. I am trying to access. This is small letter S. I am trying to have access to this. So what will be my output if I try to this output? What I am going to get actually? The output I should get. Arvind is a animal. Arvind is an animal. What is what I am going to get actually? Now if I want to get print for the second line, it will be your Tommy is a same thing. I'm going to repeat, but here I'm going to use a format. This is dog2 dot underscore class dot species. I'm going to have access to the species. So what will be the output for this actually? If I try to do this, my output will be, okay, Arvind is a animal. Okay, Tommy is a animal. This is what I'm going to get. So now if I want to have access to this description, okay, so that is your instance description or instant attributes. If I want to do that, I can print it. Just I'm going to do accessing the instance. Okay, that is description or attributes. Instance description or instant attributes. If I want to print it, so let me use this print command. Print of what? So you have the flower bracket is, so in the first flower bracket I should be able to get the name, second flower bracket I should get its age. So many years. Okay, dot format. Okay, here I am going to use dog1 dot name, dog1 dot age. Okay, then close the bracket. So similarly for the second one, I should be able to get, open the flower bracket, is so many years dot format dot dog2 dot name comma dog2 dot age. Close it. Then what will be the output for it actually? The output for this will be, so Arvind is, okay, how many years? 8 years. 8 years is the dog's name. And Tommy is 6 years. So that's how you will be, see, this is a very simple program we have created defining the class. Okay, defining the class with the name dog. Then we defined its attributes. Okay, what are the attributes? Attributes are nothing but characteristic of that particular object. Okay, then we have used the init class. See, I init method of the class, it is nothing but initializer method. Okay, so initializer method of defining the class, I will discuss on this particular, because there's a, I need a little bit of, at least 10 to 20 minutes of discussion on this init method of describing the class. It is nothing but, to be very precise, it is the first run method in the object when it is created. Okay, first run method. So that's why it is called as initialization method. Okay, initializer method. Then what you have done is actually we have defined in the parent class, we have defined two description or reference. Okay, one is dog one, other one is dog two. Okay, so what are those actually? Those are reference values to your new objects. What are the new objects I have defined? Dog one and dog two reference to that. So then we are using the class attributes. So what is the class attribute? Underscore class. See, this is nothing but I'm using two class attributes. One is this particular underscore class. This is the attributes what I'm trying to use it here. This is the one. One is with respect to what I've defined. Suppose if I define it, it belongs to something like what type of animal, maybe pet animals. I would have got pet animals. So you just simply have defining whatever the thing I'm trying to define, I'm trying to get it. Okay. Then see, the class attributes are the same for all the instances of the class. See, the class attributes, the animal, what I have defined, it is same for all the classes. So we can access it. So we can access the your instance attributes by going to the function. Okay, by going to the function, maybe something like It's a myself dot name means it's a dog one dot name. So myself dot to myself dot age means it's a dog two dot age. That's what I have done here. That's what I have done here. Dog one dot name and dog one dot age. Dog two dot name and dog two dot age. This is what I have done, and I'm able to get the instance attributes. Okay. Every instance I'm trying to take it and get it printed. Is that clear? Any doubts? I think this example should be able to, I think your doubts, if you're able to, what are the doubts in your mind, no? You should be able to get it clarified.
Yes, sir. It's clear, sir.
Yes, fine. Now, there is something called as class methods. So we'll go to the next topic. Now, we will take up the examples. I will
Sir,
take up
there's one
the.
doubt in the chat box.
Yeah, I think let me look into that. Chat box. Yes, sir. Species in Nikhil Singh. Yeah. Sir, species instance can directly access by dog dot species, dog one. No, dog one dot species is the instance attribute. And species is the directly an attribute. Okay. Instances are nothing but I'm going to description. You see, it's something like, so well, let me give a best example. Maybe I will take the example of a cars. Okay. You have a set of cars. Maybe we have different manufacturers. Maybe Maruti or Hyundai, Kia Motors. Maybe let me take these three. So under Maruti, you will be having different cars. Under Hyundai, you will be having different cars. So under Kia, you will be having different cars. Think of that particular thing. Now, if you look at it actually, say under Maruti. So right now, maybe we'll take some two cars. Maybe we can take the Wagoneer. Or you can take the Seltos, or maybe from Tata, or maybe from Maruti, you can take maybe CS. So one or two cars you take. When this car was introduced, okay, when this car was introduced, whether it's 2015, Wagoneer, which was introduced in 2005. So if you look at it actually, the 2005, 2007, those are called as instant attributes. Okay, instant attributes, Wagoneer 2005. CS 2015. Maybe Hyundai. In that Hyundai, you have, say, for example, Santro, which was introduced in 2001. Okay. Now, what are these actually? They all belong to class. Class is cars. Under this, actually, what is your in species actually? They all belong to a particular species. So, what is the species? Maybe under Maruti. So, under Hyundai, under Kia, if you look at it, that is called as your attributes. You got it? So under this particular thing, I'm going to define it. Nikhil, is that clear? Okay, fine. Thank you. So,
Sir,
yeah. That's
sir,
correct.
instead of that dog one dot underscore underscore class underscore underscore dot species, we can write it as dog dot species, class
No.
name dot species. We'll
Yeah,
get the
no.
same outputs.
Yeah, you'll get it actually. But if you define the class, so if this being a first class, maybe when you go for when you go for an advanced programming, then the class actually underscore class can be removed. Okay. So dog one dot species will get the same output. You'll get an output. But as the initial programmer, I should know what exactly
No,
is it
sir.
actually.
Dog one is this thing, no, sir. Object.
It's an object. Yes,
I'm
it's an
telling
object.
class names are dog dot species.
Yes,
We'll
Mr.
get the.
Yes, you'll get an output. Your output will be same, but they belong to which class? I want to show it. That's it. So this is a very simple program to show that. See, I want you people to introduce you to this particular thing. Init. What is it actually? Init. So that belong to this particular class. So dog one dot species, dog two dot species, or dog one dot name, dog one dot age. So it all will give similar kind of an output. Species will get animal. You'll get an output. Output will be the same. You can get a dog one dot species also, you'll get an output as animal. You can get it. But it belongs to which class? To show that it's a belong to class attribute, I'm trying to write it. Is that clear? But you should understand that
Yes.
that is a class, this is a class attribute. Just to differentiate that, I have done this. Once you get comfortable, you can use it. Is that clear? Fine. Now, what is this class methods? Okay, we'll go to the next topic. Methods, actually. Class methods. Class methods. See, we have defined functions. Okay, all the functions defined in a particular class are called as, see, all the functions. All the functions defined in a class are called as methods. What it is actually, if I try to define, see, why this particular thing is required for us. Because when I use a function, they will try to define its behavior of the object. Okay. So when I define a function, so the function is nothing but the function is going to tell about the class. At the same time, the class are used to define the behavior of that particular object. So I can tell that your methods, they are used to define the behavior of the object. What it is actually? Behavior of the object means actually what I am trying to do. Okay, what it is doing. If you go back here, I told that any object will have two types of characteristics. One is an attribute, and if I want to define its behavior, I will try to do using the functions. Okay. Now, maybe if I try to look at the example. So, say for example, I told that you have a thing what is called as a dog. Now, dog can bark. So, dog can dance. Maybe if you take dog can sing. Or maybe if you take a particular person. So, what is his? If you take a particular student or a person, if I try to define his name, age, email ID, phone number, all those things, they all belong to what is called as attributes. Now, what he can do? So he can be a good singer, or he can do he's a good swimmer, or if he's good at athletics, or he can play football. So all these things are called as its behaviors. So your function will help in defining these behaviors, so in a much better fashion. So that's why this class methods play very, very important role in defining this class methods. Is that clear? Okay.